Talk about your storybook endings.
Howard's your leader. Hopgood is third. Johnson on the high side. He leans on Howard. Here comes Hopgood. It's going to be Woody Howard, your winner tonight.
And some new numbers on the leaderboard.
Daniel Johnson, I'm looking at the big board, and I see 3 second.
Man, it was an awesome run for us.
Round two of the Hooters Pro Cup Championship chase begins with two veterans leading the points. This is a series where anything can happen, and it usually does. So the 2006 championship story is far from over. Welcome to Jennerstown Speedway. We're in Jennerstown, Pennsylvania for the restart of the Charlie Campbell Memorial Miller Lite 250 presented by Predator Performance. Second race of the USAR Hooters Pro Cup Championship Series here in 2006. Hello again, everyone. I'm Rick Benjamin. Scott Sutherland is alongside, and Brett McMillan will have the coverage for us today here on Pit Road. 49 laps completed last night. The weather today is a whole lot better. The rains came, forced a red flag. We'll restart this afternoon. Pretty chilly, though, here in the mountains of Western PA.
Your Pepsi weather report, 54 degrees is real chilly. A little bit of a breeze out there. Shouldn't be a problem for these engines staying cool. Big problem as far as crew chiefs paying attention to detail. And this was the Pepsi weather report last night.
The Hooters Pro Cup stars fought drizzle all day and all evening, but 49 laps were run. Hirsch and grandson Torrey representing Predator Performance. They were the Grand Marshals. Jason Knisley of Predator dropped the green flag as the honorary starter. Benny Gordon was the early leader. Monty Gill sustaining some damage to the USG Sheetrock Gymnock board early in the race. 7 laps in, a tangle here between Johnny Rumley and Benny Gordon. Everyone would stay straight, and Gordon was the leader. Now at lap 19, Danji Hennifer's blown motor oiled the track. Rumley gets up into the wall. Matt Carter and Jody Lavender involved. The car of Joey Logano also heavily damaged. On lap 46, Woody Howard cuts a tire in the Dean Motorsports 55. He would have to make a premature pit stop. And on lap 49, the rain returned. It became very heavy. The USAR Hooters Pro Cup officials decided to throw the red flag, thus leading us to our restart here on Sunday afternoon. It is overcast and chilly. October dawns, and fall is definitely here. But the crowd has returned to Jennerstown Speedway. Let's size up what we're likely to see this afternoon on the restart. Brett McMillan with Gene Crane.
Well, guys, how USAR is handling this switch to the next day is it's basically the longest red flag that Gene and I have ever been a part of. Under red flag conditions, though, teams normally not allowed to work on their cars, but Gene, we're seeing the 80 and the 84 both work on theirs, so what are we going to do about that?
Well, Brett, they're allowed to work on their cars. They're electing to take a 2-lap penalty. That is per the USAR Hooters Pro Cup Series rule books. These teams were involved in the crash that happened just prior to the red flag coming out. These teams are in the point battle. They're trying to get their way back up front. Johnny Rumley came in fourth. It's important to get back on the track, even if they are 2 laps down, complete laps, and improve their finishing position here this evening.
You know, I think that they, under these conditions, why wouldn't you work on your car? You know, they've just had about 3 hours worth of work on their car, which normally would have finished the race, and they're only going to be penalized 2 laps.
Well, that's the way the rule is set up, and normally a red flag may be 10 minutes, 15 minutes for a situation that cleanup needs to clean up on the speedway, not a delay for rain. Rain, unfortunately, came our way. We're having to deal with it here today.
All right, now we've got 49 laps in the books before the green flag comes back out, or at least the yellow flag comes back out here again. What are we going to see strategy-wise?
It's an interesting call. I talked to Benny Gordon. I've got a feeling you're going to see several teams come to pit road once the once the race is restarted. We will begin lap counting. Once we're counting laps, the pits will be open for a normal pit stop sequence. Teams can come down pit road, change tires, get a full load of fuel, which most have been able to go ahead and load up with fuel as it is right now. But they'll come to pit road possibly, make some changes. But what changes do you make? That's the big question.
Well, one thing we heard before the race started last night was short pitting. You can't make it to the end of the race from where you're at right now, fuel-wise, but track position's key. So, Scott, what do you think you do in a situation like this?
Guys, your guess is as good as mine, but here's what I think. If I was in the back part of the field, say from the middle back, I would come down pit road, take a good look at my race car, probably change the tires on it. I can use that set later. And maybe make a couple little adjustments. If I'm in the front of the field, it's hard to give up that track position.
Well, the drivers and crews getting ready to do battle here at Jennerstown with 201 laps to go. Mike Herman Jr. and the Fireside Hearth at Home Chevy among those drivers hoping to go to victory lane today at Jennerstown. We'll be back for the restart.
Now you can get all your best-loved country hits together in the Time Life Classic Country Collection.
Just walk on by.
Wait on the corner.
Fell in Husky.
On the wings of the snow white dove. He sends his pure sweet love.
Patsy Cline. Conway Twitty. Jim Reeves. Tammy Wynette. And the one and only Marty Robbins.
Out in the West Texas town of El Paso, I fell in love with a Mexican girl.
Every song in the 6-CD Classic Country Collection is the original recording, no re-records, and they're all digitally remastered for the best sound ever.
They say don't go on Wolverton Mountain.
You walk by and I fall to pieces.
You will get the breakthrough hits of the 50s, the classics of the 60s, the best of the 70s. Songs we'll always remember, by the stars we'll never forget. Each album comes complete with historic photos and stories about the stars and their music. Plus, use your credit card and you'll get this Hank Williams album free, featuring 25 of his legendary hits. So call now to enjoy the Classic Country Collection on 6 CDs. If it's not the best country collection you've ever heard, just send it back for a full refund. Plus, use your credit card and get your free Hank Williams bonus album. That's 115 country hits in all. So don't wait. Call the number on your screen now.
Starting October 1st, NASCAR moves to Satanta Sports Ireland and Sky Channel 438. Don't miss a minute of the action from the chase to the Nextel Cup. Exclusively live on this special primetime edition of NASN Extra. Watch live coverage from the green flag to the checkered flag. Every lap from every race for the rest of the season. Visit NASN.com for more details. Don't forget, live NASCAR is moving to Satanta Sports Ireland and Sky Channel 438.
Welcome back to Jennerstown Speedway, the Charlie Gamble Memorial Miller Lite 250. 49 laps are on Saturday night before the rains came. Preparing for a restart here with 201 to go this afternoon. Let's have a look now at what we're going to call our Naturally Fresh Foods running order here today. This is how the field will take the green for the restart. Benny Gordon will start from the pole position when we go again. That's the Predator Performance 4. Clay Rogers alongside the Automotive Development Group, car number 44. A.J. Frank was running third in the 11 car. Gary St. Avant of the Jakes.com Chevrolet. Shelby Howard is next in line. Here's your second 10, Marty Lindley and Michael Rich. Jack Bailey and Kirk Leone. Sam Fallone and the Perros Vegetables Machine. And Tim Bainey Jr. Shane Wallace in his own Ford. J.J. Pack, Wayne Willard, Mike Herman Jr., as we saw earlier. Red Butler restarts 21st with Dominic Casola. Mike Mason moves into the Awesome Awnings car. There's Daniel Johnson, second at Iowa Speedway. Michelle Ferriel, Hobgood, Jeff Fultz, Andrew Rogers, Jim Crabtree, and Woody Howard. Bobby Gill will restart 31st. Matt Carter and Joey Logano are behind the wall. Lonnie Rush Jr. will line up 34th. Danji Hannaford is done. Johnny Rumley and Jody Lavender will return, as we heard. Eric Corbett's been disqualified. Ninth pole this year for Benny Gordon.
It's great to get that record, and when we got here, the track was so much different than what we tested, and the car was nowhere near as fast as what we knew it could be, so we had our work cut out for us today. This Predator Performance team, Don Benton and Todd Smith, my Uncle Pete, and Joey McKee, those guys work in this shop every week, and they worked their butts off today along with the rest of the guys, and just proud of them and proud of the effort we put in to get these pole awards and to be on the pole in the championship race here. So tons of people from Dubois here to cheer us on, Predator sponsoring the race. Want to thank the Ray Bucks and Murray's Ford and everybody behind us. So hopefully we can be out front like we were in qualifying.
That is your Advanced Auto Parts pole winner. But the thing is, the last couple races we've seen him win the pole, his car hasn't been that good during the race. So I'm curious to see, can he make it last the whole day?
And the transition from night racing to day racing, and it'll be quite a bit cooler than a lot of these teams probably anticipated. On board looks today with Shelby Howard. We'll have the Lucas Oil camera on board the Speedco, Tony Stewart Motorsports car number 20, Howard out of Indiana. Michael Rich lines up 12th. That's the Naturally Fresh camera on board the Jackaroo Meat Sauces Ford. And we'll take a ride today with Brett Butler in the 99 South. That, of course, the Aaron's Dream Machine as Michael Rich gets set to go. Butler starts 21st, coming off a couple of very good runs to wrap up the season. The Aaron's Dream Machine, that's one of the Michael Waltrip entries, and he is back in the 11th row as we get set to go racing. Fatheads.com safety car with the lights still on, the wheel and light bar up on top. And your lead lap cars will start on the outside. Bobby Gill with the damage to that Kimnock Ford. He'll line up alongside Benny Gordon. Scott, show us around Jennerstown Speedway.
Well, what a unique racetrack. Long, sweeping corners, a little bit flat through the middle. So you got to be very careful as you enter. And it's really tough to get traction and still turn. There's a little bit of a bump going into three. Always tough for the drivers to get across it. But what a great facility to be wide open.
They love their short track stock car racing here in western Pennsylvania. The fans always turn out in droves at Jennerstown. What about the strategy here this afternoon?
Got a few out the racetrack. Going to start all over. We only got about an hour of practice yesterday because of the rain. So we got to start all over again today and adjust the race car as what the racetrack is going to do during the afternoon. And you better get that fuel, but you want to be able to. You got to get in that area of about 160 laps. You're going to make it. Any more than that, you're really playing that Russian roulette style.
Well, 54 laps are on the board. We've scored a couple of laps under caution here. So you've got 196 to go. Safety car dives for the infield. Benny Gordon will lead them to the restart here at Jennerstown Speedway. Glad to have you with us. We are back underway. Clay Rogers in second position, and Gordon takes off at his home racetrack. Great start for Gordon in that Predator Performance Ford. He's had the fastest car in the place all day. Following the Jakes.com Chevrolet of Gary St. Amant, riding here with Shelby Howard. Bobby Gill unable to get a lap back, and as much damage as was done to the 06 aerodynamically, you've got to think he just doesn't have the speed today.
Well, there's a couple of things. They've got to really feel their race car out. They've got to make sure that this thing is going to drive halfway decent. There's a lot of things can be bent. If it drives good, he can go ahead and go. Oh, and caution.
Caution already. Just underway on the restart on a sunny now Sunday afternoon. Sam Filone in the 48 car, Trevor Bayne in the McDonald's number 29 have gotten together and gone around, and that brings out the yellow just after the restart. We'll have a look there. Looks like both cars suffered just a little bit of damage. Should be able to refire. Sam Filone already pulling away in his Pontiac Body Pyros Vegetables machine. Well, Trevor Bayne is the Miller Lite Rookie of the Year points leader coming into the afternoon. He's already collected $10,000 for earning South Tour Rookie of the Year honors. If he can close the deal during the championship series, another $40,000 goes into his coffers, getting ready for 2007, one of the richest Rookie of the Year awards in all of short track racing. They're going to need to bump start to 29 to get him going. Here's another look.
Trevor Bayne with a great runoff turn two up underneath Sam Filone. A little bit of contact in the left rear of the 48 car. Around they both go. The biggest problem Trevor Bayne had, he couldn't get it refired. So he sat there and went a lap down. Finally gets a push and he's back and running.
Now the McDonald's Fusion is away and he will get set for the restart here at Jennerstown.
It's all about love.
Always and forever.
Dancing close.
Each moment.
Kisses when the lights are low. It's the sound of classic soul ballads. For the first time ever, all the most romantic soul hits are together in one collection. Time Life Music presents Classic Soul Ballads. 90 of the most beautiful, the most sensual, and the sexiest songs of all time. You could spend hours of time and hundreds of pounds trying to collect all the beautiful music in the Classic Soul Ballads collection. But if you order now, you can own the entire collection, 90 hits, on 6 CDs for just 4 easy monthly payments. But wait, call with your credit card and we'll send you a free Marvin Gaye early classic CD. That's an additional 18 tracks from soul legend Marvin Gaye. You'll get a total of 7 CDs, 108 of the greatest soul hits of all time. This special collection is not sold in stores. So call now with your credit card and get the Classic Soul Ballads collection and your free Marvin Gaye early classic CD. From soul legends to golden groups, this collection will touch your heart and make you feel good all over. Call the number on your screen now.
Returns to NASN.
Back at Jennerstown, getting set for a restart. Benny Gordon will have the restart pole. Lead lap cars on the outside. So far, Benny Gordon has been astonishingly fast.
Yeah, but we've only had short segments of racing. He hasn't been able to get up and really get after to see what his car is going to be on the long haul. Maybe we can get a chance to get going here.
Restart on lap 61. Gordon, Clay Rogers, that's A.J. Frank in third in front of Gary St. Amant and Shelby Howard. And Rogers tracking right behind Gordon. Frank able to turn down in front of Bobby Gill and cement third. St. Amant right there in fourth. Shelby Howard's got a quick race car today in that Speedco Truck Loops Tony Stewart car. But Gordon in the Predator Performance Ford, the defending series champion, has set sail at Jennerstown. Now Howard trying to sneak to the inside and get around St. Amant. Jeff Agnew in sixth in front of Woody Howard. St. Amant closes the door on Howard for the moment. Howard able to run down to the bottom. Let's get on board the 20.
Woo! Spotter's got to let you know if he's up underneath. You don't need to be tagged and go around. It's way too early to race. Be trading too much paint, Rick.
Shelby Howard wants to get around Gary St. Amant. Must feel as though he's got a much quicker race car. He sees Benny Gordon setting sail up there.
Wow, his car really sticks on the bottom, and he's there that time.
Now, Gary St. Amant is the kind of race driver, I would think if he knows the 20 is faster, he'd let him go.
Well, the deal is with these cars, there's so much headgear around you. It's hard to see how the car's relying on a mirror. You've got to have that spotter to say inside, inside. Otherwise, you're going down to that bottom group.
Shelby Howard makes the inside pass on St. Amant. So the 20th hour of the Speedco Truck Loops machine moves to fourth, doubling St. Amant of the Jags.com Chevy back to fifth. The Mark IV Honda 73 car of Agnew remains in sixth. Woody Howard back to seventh. Now remember, Howard had a cut tire last night. He had to battle back, and here comes Jay Fogelman on the inside. A little further back, Justin Hobgood, Michael Rich. There's Sam Fallone in the Pirro's Vegetables car. Brett Butler in the Aaron's Dream Machine there, the 99. Bobby, good battle for position.
Bobby Gill in the front of this train, just kind of holding these guys up. Car not up to speed, so the guys are down in that bottom group. Really no place to go.
That white 71 behind Gill, that's the car of Lonnie Rush Jr. Ray Skillman Auto Chevrolet riding here with Butler behind Rich in the Jackaroo Sauces engine. Brett Butler really starting to figure this thing out in Hooters Pro Cup competition. And a top 10 at Lakeland a few weeks back. Jody Lavender right in front of him in the 84 car, the H&R Block entry. You can tell it was a rough night here with the wet conditions last night. A lot of cars falling into the category of walking wounded, trying to stay on the lead lap. There's Derek Kale in the 22, behind Fallone. Lavender on the outside in that blue car now, the 48. See Andrew Rogers there in the 18. That is the Termidor Aaron's Pontiac, the red car in the back of the pack.
Now most of these cars in the back all came down pit road before we went back to green, made those adjustments, topped it off with fuel so they could get ready for a long run if it were to happen.
Gill in the 06. Many laps down after the incident last night. Up front it remains Benny Gordon, your leader. On the inside, Lonnie Rush there. There's Cale in the 22. Behind Rush, on the outside, Fallone. Battling for position back in the field. Dominic Cassola there in the 02. Wayne Willard in the Bowen Holmes 01 trying to get going.
You and I talked about it before we got going here today. That outside group is going to be tough to get around, and they're really going to have to work the outside because of all lap traffic on the bottom here today.
Cassola up high. Lavender swings up on the high side. Oh, and a piece comes flying off some contact back there. Looks as though Willard might have gotten into the back end of that car he's moving by. That's Casola's 02. And we saw some shrapnel go flying, but we stayed green. Michelle Theriault in the team Glock car. Daniel Johnson in the Charlotte check cashers entry. That's the three car that ran second at Iowa Speedway. His best career finish, nearly stole the victory. Woody Howard came on. He was fourth with a lap to go. Howard with a great run to get to victory lane in the first of the six championship series races here in 2006.
Oh, oh.
Contact and Lonnie Rush. Lonnie Rush gets punted and the 71 car goes up the racetrack and into the wall. So the Devers Chevrolet, the Ray Skillman auto car, Rush in trouble. He folds up the right front corner of that car and we are under yellow. Looked as though the caution had started to wave. Lonnie might have backed out of the gas and got punted.
A lot of times that'll happen. Everybody rolls out of the gas, and if the guy behind you doesn't see the caution flag or a spotter hasn't told him, he's still wide open, and it only takes, bang, just a second, and you're sending the guy around, in this case, Lonnie Rush, into the wall.
Lonnie's team over the wall to have a look at the Chevrolet, but it looks as though it incurred some serious right front corner damage. You can see the brace bars there pretty badly bent. That right front wheel folded up under the bodywork. That could be the end of the day.
Yeah, it took both upper and lower control arm, probably bent the spindle, and you'll watch him go down into the corner. Now everybody starts rolling out of the gas. They see the yellow lights on, except for the guy behind him. He can't see it. And bang, into that outside wall.
Looked like rookie Derek Cale, who tagged Rush in the quarter panel and sent the 71 car up the racetrack. Under caution once again. Leaders will head to pit road now on lap 78. Can you get all the way home here?
I think they can. We're going to find out. Brett is down there in the 66 car.
Benny Gordon leads the parade down pit road. He comes to a stop in his pit stall. They're ready for a four-tire change. They wanted to go ahead, get a few laps under their belt under daytime conditions and see how the car was handling. So far, not a wrench on this car at all. So they're still very happy with it after a lot of gnashing of teeth yesterday during their practice. He peels out. Benny's away. First one off pit road. Daniel Johnson right behind him. And then here comes Shelby Howard, Clay Rogers.
And the 93 car also getting off pit road quickly. There's the 73 of Agnew. So that's a pretty impressive statement, I think, if they don't make any changes on the 66 car.
Well, if you're leading the race and you've won the pole, you've been leading the race, and it looks like he can just lead at will, I wouldn't change anything. No way.
Well, Benny Gordon down and away quickly and a very good pit stop for Daniel Johnson's team. But Gary St. Amant stays on the racetrack. He'll be the restart pole sitter when we come back.
Hi, I'm Tom Glavine of the New York Mets. Watch live Major League Baseball all season long on NASA, Europe's number one channel for MLB.
It's no fun when you can't sleep. Time seems to stand still. You just can't switch off. And it feels like you're the only one. But you don't have to put up with it. Night Owl can help you drift off into a natural sleep. So you wake up refreshed in the morning. Good mornings follow a good Night Owl.
He was passionate for football. Every Sunday, Saturday, I'd be anywhere in London in the rain and in the snow. I remember he used to say things like, you know what, Mum, you're not just my mum, you're my best mate as well. we was watching a documentary, and then he goes to me, so Mum, you know, if anything happened to me, are you saying they could take my heart and they could put it in someone who's sick? And I went, yeah. And he went, that's what I want to do, you know. Then he made a joke, he goes, could there be a wicked goalkeeper? I'm just happy that there are people out there who are able to still be with their family because of what Junior's done. But what Junior did was just Junior.
Starting October 1st, NASCAR moves to Satanta Sports Ireland and Sky Channel 438. Don't miss a minute of the action from the chase to the Nextel Cup. Exclusively live on this special primetime edition of NASN Extra. Watch live coverage from the green flag to the checkered flag. Every lap from every race for the rest of the season. Visit NASN.com for more details. Don't forget, live NASCAR is moving to Satanta Sports Ireland and Sky Channel 438.
Back at Jennerstown Speedway, getting set for another restart. Now, the teams pitted, those leaders that came to pit road, Scott, with about 80 laps on the board. You said they could go 160 on a tank of fuel here. They're counting on cautions if they think they can get all the way
yeah,
home.
Yeah, I think you can just try to get you a few cautions. You're going to anticipate what's going to happen. A lot of these cats right here in the front of the field, now, they came in and got their fuel. So they can stretch this thing a lot longer, save those tires for the end of the race.
Fatheads.com safety car dives from pit road. Gary St. Amant brings him back to green. Back underway at Jennerstown. Beginning lap number 82. Woody Howard trying to get a lap back, and he will do so, as will Johnny Rumley. St. Amant having problems getting up to speed.
Well, I think the big thing is that bottom groove is a huge advantage at this place. There's so much more bite early in the race like this. They got a great runoff on the bottom. Trevor Bayne trying to get one of his laps back. I'll tell you, some of the fast cars like Woody Howard, I don't know if you want him to get back on that lead lap.
Woody Howard has done so, and of course he won the championship series opener a couple of weeks ago at the new Iowa Speedway. Now Trevor Bayne in the McDonald's Ford out of Knoxville, Tennessee at age 15, he's gotten a lap back as well. Remember, he was in a tangle with Sam Fallone earlier on the backstretch, gets one of his two laps back, and Kirk Leone on the inside. Now that's for the lead, Scott.
Well, Gary St. Amant won the lead, and he wanted to lead some. But he's only going to get one or two laps here. Kirk Leone with a great race car.
And Percy Johnson excavating forward. He's out of North Carolina. Put Leone at the top of the leaderboard now. Gary St. Amant settles into second. Tim Bainey rides third. Good early run for Bainey in that greased lightning car. Meantime, Lonnie Rush is behind the wall. He's with Brett.
Well, Lonnie, I know that you're really disappointed. You had things going so well in the championship hunt. What put you out?
Well, we were slowing down for that yellow flag, and another competitor decided to run over us, and I'm pretty upset with how they decided to handle it, but I wanted to thank Levitt Racing Chassis for helping us out to get to this race, and as always Race Gilman for helping us throughout the year, and every one of these guys on the team, because they're the ones that make this happen week in, week out.
Really tough situation, because a lot of times your spotter will tell you what's going on the racetrack. If that spotter behind you or in front of you doesn't hear the same thing, if he's not aware of what's going on, he'll miss it, and you end up in a wreck because of that.
Battle for second. Tim Bainey Jr. on the outside of Gary St. Amant. Put Bainey up now into second spot. Drives around the Jegs.com Chevy. Also want to give a call to young Mike Mason in his rookie season. Back this week, they've parked the family-owned team. He takes over the Premier Motorsports 8 car. That's the awesome awnings machine. And Mason up in the top five as well. Now for the top spot on the outside, Bainey going around Kirk Leone. Tim Bainey Jr. is the leader.
Somebody black flag the 15 car. I want to make sure that's Tim Bainey in it, because going to the outside at Jennerstown is not easy. To do it, we'll take the lead. That's really something. Awesome.
Now Tim Bainey is from this area. In fact, he has a late model win on a weekly show under his belt here at Jennerstown this season, but that's by far the best run I've ever seen him turn in this machine.
Okay, late model. This is Hooters Pro Cup Series action, and wow, that was strong.
Well, Tim Bainey, 6 car lengths into the lead now. Brett downstairs with his crew chief.
Dan Bainey, crew chief. You guys haven't pitted yet. What's your thought process?
Well, not much for rain at a racetrack, but about 25 laps, I wouldn't mind seeing it rain here. Kind of going to hang out for a while. They let us fill the cars back up this morning. So we're good about 200 or something like that, but it's a good run for the Grease Lightning, Ford and the whole team. You know, it's our home track, Jennerstown here, so hopefully we can get some kind of luck here and, you know, come back up through if we have to and get a winner, top five or something.
Tim Bainey just needs to be smart here. Don't worry about the lap cars in front of you. Just keep an eye on who's second, how far he is behind you, and just cruise. Put laps under your belt and get ready for this race car to really come to you or to make those changes for later in the race.
Now Kirk Leone in the 52 settles into second spot in front of St. Amant. Fourth is Mike Mason there, the Awesome Awnings car number 8. On the charge in fifth position, the 16. That's the North Division 16. That's young J.J. Pack in the mix there. So great battle for position. All of this helping Tim Bainey. He's set sail now. Side by side, Rogers and Benny Gordon. Andrew Rogers in the Termidor. Aaron's car number 18. Looks like he's got just as much speed there as Benny Gordon does. Down into the corner, Pack on the inside of St. Amant for position. That's for fourth.
They're racing hard side by side. Whoa,
oh,
whoa, whoa.
J.J. Pack goes around. He takes St. Amant with him. Andrew Rogers just misses. They lock down the brakes, but the yellow will wave. Here, our sixth caution already, and it's only lap 95 at Jennerstown. Pack had come up 31 positions before that spin.
Car got just a little bit loose right in the middle of the corner. Came around, collected the 72 of St. Amant right in front of the 66 and the 44. Benny Gordon and Clay Rogers.
Pack among those cars that did not pit when the leaders came to pit road just a few laps ago before our previous restart. Able to take track position instead of fresh tires. One more look.
And you can see the car got loose going into the corner, and he was trying everything he could to save it. And then all of a sudden the back of his car get into Gary St. Amant, and around they both go. Wow, the 18 just gets by.
Well, the thing that saved Pack was he was able to lean on St. Amant's Chevy. Here's a look from the 20 car, Shelby Howard.
And how this didn't catch up more race cars. Guys were really paying attention on the brakes and getting out of there.
Quick pit stop for Kirk Leone. Tires for the Percy Johnson Excavating Ford. Leone led a few laps a few moments ago. He will take the opportunity to grab tires and top off with fuel. Jeff Fultz there in the CNC Boilers Pontiac, also on pit road. Gary St. Amant stopping the Jakes.com Chevy. They're going to have to pull the sheet metal away. The left front corner of that race car. We'll be back with more from Jennerstown.
Hi, I'm Torrey Hunt of the Minnesota Twins. Watch live Major League Baseball all season long on NASN. Europe's number one channel for Major League Baseball.
Ever wished you could be there to see your team in action? With Game On Holidays, you can combine that big match atmosphere with the holiday of a lifetime for the whole family. We offer city breaks and holidays, incorporating all U.S. sports, including NASCAR. All you have to do is visit our website and choose the games or races you want to see, and we'll do the rest. Great seats, great games, great value. Game on. This season, Setanta Sports is bringing you more of Europe's elite football than anyone else. And Setanta viewers can now watch even more Scottish Premier League games than ever before. 60 games, exclusively live. And now you get to see Setanta Sports 7 days a week. More goals, more action, more play. Setanta Sports, now 7 days a week.
Welcome back to Jennerstown. The green is back in the air. And your restart leader is Tim Bainey Jr. Second spot belongs to Mike Mason and Andrew Rogers restarting third. Bainey rolling by the Jody Lavender car, the H&R Block 4. Sam Pallone down on the bottom there in the 48, the Bureau's Vegetables entry. There's the champion spark plugs 80, the Junior Motorsports Chevy. Johnny Rumley got in the wall Saturday night. They fixed the car so he can run, but he's just not up to speed. On board with Shelby Howard.
Those guys down on the bottom, they got tore up race cars, but you know what? They've still got to get out here and get laps and try to get as many positions as they can. This is all about points racing. Riding along with Shelby Howard, get a good view of how to get through traffic and take care of your race car.
Clay Rogers up ahead in the 44, the Johnny Suzuki Baird Transport Automotive Development Group entry. Benny Gordon now to the bottom, wants to get by Andrew Rogers. 100 laps on the board. Aaron's running order top of your screen, and Gordon is third. Rogers battling with Andrew Rogers for fourth.
Keep in mind these top three. Andrew Rogers hasn't gone in and gotten tires yet. The rest of these cats have. They're coming up. They're going to be a little bit quicker. But what about it? This is great stories. Mike Mason running second. Andrew Rogers trying to stay in the top five. And Tim Bainey Jr. leading this race.
Tim Bainey laying down some impressive laps here at Jennerstown. Clay Rogers, meantime, will move inside the Terminator car of Andrew Rogers, pick up a spot. Shelby Howard keeps the 20 car down on the yellow line as well, and he will gain a position. So Andrew Rogers at this point, I'm sure, thinking, hey, we need a caution so I can get this thing to pit road.
Well, maybe not. You know, ooh, a little bit loose right there, trying to keep up with the leaders. Just ride now. Go ahead and let those leaders run those tires. Go out there, go as fast as you can. Beat Jackrabbit. Because when you get to about 50 or 60 from the end, I'll come get my new tires.
Benny Gordon, meantime, going after Mike Mason on the inside, and Gordon takes second away from the young driver from Bakersfield, California. So Benny Gordon, the pole award winner here from Advance Auto Parts. Of course, that Longhorn win from the pole bonus in play for him as well. Mason in the 8 car, one of those drivers who has not yet pitted. Our Team Hooters Challenge winner today selected Gordon as the driver likeliest to win in her eyes, Helen Burkett. And she will go to victory lane with Benny and the team if Gordon does win here today at Jennerstown in the Charlie Campbell Memorial Miller Lite 250. Daniel Johnson running in front of Marty Lindley in the Black Tire Service 22. There's Agnew in the Mark IV Honda Chevy. That's the 73. Derek Cale back there, rookie contender, in car number 22. Lindley now to the inside of Daniel Johnson. Lindley, of course, the winner at Bristol midsummer in his first drive in that Black Tire Service Ford. Marty Lindley will pick up a spot. Oh, up the racetrack. Opens the door for Agnew. Agnew comes by on the inside. Can't get around Lindley, though.
Lindley and Johnson had a little bit of contact. What happens when your wheels hit? They lock together. Neither one can turn. They had to just wait till they bounced off each other in order to go. By then, they'd moved up. Open the door for Jeff Agnew.
Agnew picks up a position now. Daniel Johnson in front of Derek Cale in the 22. So Agnew, former Hooters Cup national champion back in 1999. There's the Jackaroo Sauces car. Let's get on board here with Michael Rich, 22nd in the championship after the Iowa Speedway run a couple of weeks ago. He needs a good run here today.
Just be consistent. Just hang in there all day long. You can see his car runs the bottom. Looks pretty smooth. He's not working the wheel very hard. Goes across the bump into three real well. Just a lot of traffic. These guys are all running about the same speed. Very difficult to get position.
Brett Butler up ahead there in the Aaron's Dream Machine, the 99. Rich will get by him on the inside.
Good move by Brett Butler. I'm sorry, Rip, but he watched his hand go out the window to wave Michael Rich on by. He knows how fast he is and let him go.
A lot of laps to go. No reason to get in trouble here. We're not even to halfway yet. Tim Bainey Jr. continues to lead, but Benny Gordon, Brett McMillan, is tracking down the leader.
You guys are watching Benny Gordon battle for the lead here. I think back to the conversation we had before this race, in which Benny said that after the disappointing run they had in Iowa that dropped him to third in the points, he came here to Jennerstown knowing this is a track he loves, knowing this is a track he runs well at, but also knowing this is a track he has to leave with a good finish at. He's not going to stick his nose in there and make something happen just to get to the front. It's more important that he finish near the front and have a great points day.
Okay, Brett, do you believe that?
No.
I've watched this guy race too many times. If there's an opening, he's taking it, and he's going to run as hard as he can, and he is working hard to take this lead back.
Well, halfway is only 13 laps away, make it 12 laps away. Bainey, a little smoke showing out of the Grease Lightning Ford on the outside. Might have a little tire rub out there, maybe a little oil smoke. He is wrestling the wheel to try and stay in front of Gordon, but Gordon can keep that 66 car down on the white line on the inside. That's where you want to be here. A little loose that time out of four.
Bainey
able to hang on to the lead.
Benny Gordon is working really hard to get back to the lead. Tim Bainey Jr., a great run to hold him back. Who'd ever thought we were going to say Tim Bainey Jr. holding off Benny Gordon?
Gordon working hard on the inside. He would like to get the lead before the cross flags and pick up the halfway bonus. Casola, meantime, alongside Daniel Johnson there in the three car. Butler in the 99. Here comes Kirk Leon back on the outside. Now Leon led laps earlier. He's got Wayne Willard in tow in the Bowen Holmes entry. Meantime, Gordon closes back in on Bainey in turn four. Longhorn running order, top of your screen. Clay Rogers is third, Shelby Howard fourth. Mike Mason hanging out on the top five, looking for an opportunity to pit. Mason, one of those cars that did not stop during that caution on lap 78. Eric Cale shown 13th in front of Rich and Johnson. And this is the battle for the top spot, the Grease Lightning Ford of Tim Bainey Jr. That battle further back, there's Johnson, Casola, Leon on the outside, Butler in the 99, Willard in the Bowen Holmes Ford.
These cats all just came in and got tires, so down there a little bit fresher tires. They're trying to make their way back up through traffic to get into contention. Meanwhile, up front, Benny Gordon is a little bit faster into the corner, but that 15 car is a rocket off the corner.
Tim Bainey opening the door for Gordon. Gordon using the bottom. Now, usually that's the way you make time here at Jennerstown, but the 66 car just isn't. And he doesn't have enough of an advantage to make that pay off.
He can't get the grip to get off the corner. The 15 car has a tremendous amount of grip off. He goes in, lets the car roll up a little bit, and then bang to the throttle. He drives off from Benny Gordon.
Meantime, lap traffic will be a factor here in a couple of moments. Leaders approaching a pack of slower cars in turn three. All right, we are five laps from halfway. Let's take a quick break and be right back here at Jennerstown. Second round of the USAR Hooters Pro Cup Championship Series here in 2006. Ivory Benjamin, Scott Sutherland alongside by McMillan with the coverage on pit road. This one originally scheduled for Saturday night. The rain after 49 laps moved the balance of the show to Sunday afternoon. Tim Bainey Jr. the leader. Benny Gordon rolls by on the outside, pinning Bainey behind a lap car. So Gordon takes the lead now, a couple of laps short of halfway. Clay Rogers moves to second. Now, why did Bainey pick the inside there?
Well, he got himself caught down in the bottom. He was anticipating the line to move just a little bit quicker, and he got himself caught. Benny Gordon made the move, and that is experience.
So Gordon to the top spot. Clay Rogers right with him in second. And now Bainey needs to get to the outside.
Well, more important, let's talk about this. Jay Fogelman now going a lap down. And there is a bunch of really good race cars right in front of Benny Gordon. These cats need a caution bad.
Halfway this time by, cross flag shown to Benny Gordon. He is our Lucas Oil halfway leader. He's led 81 laps so far on the first 125. Four lead changes thus far in the Charlie Campbell Memorial Miller Lite 250. So Gordon bags the $1,000 halfway bonus, and now he needs to take his time and work this lap traffic carefully. But what about the driver in second? Clay Rogers in the Johnny Suzuki car is right behind. Rogers would like nothing better than to hang Benny Gordon up on lap traffic and get to the front himself as he battles now with Jay Fogelman. How about the 44 car, Brett McMillan? Does Clay Rogers have a shot here today?
Yeah, the race is remaining in the championship series. This is probably Clay Rogers' least favorite. He's got two third-place finishes here, but beyond that, he doesn't have a lot of great finishes here at Jennerstown. I ask him, if he leaves here with the lead, what does that mean to the competitors? He said, it means they're in big trouble, as long as we don't beat ourselves.
Well, that's the confidence of a driver who's already won one of these Hooters Pro Cup National Championships and the $250,000 that goes along with it.
Well, I think he has a lot of confidence no matter where he's at. But I think Benny Gordon has the edge right now. He's already won the pole. He's won halfway. He's led the most laps so far. He's leading the 44 car. But we're talking about points racing. I don't see any points racing. He's got the 44 behind him. He's going for the win. Got to be.
Gordon continues to run out in front. They will put J.J. Pack a lap down. Riding here with Shelby Howard now, third in that Tony Stewart Speedco 20 car. Howard won a North Series race at Jennerstown earlier in the season. Rogers rides second, and Gordon now opens up three car lengths on the 44 of Rogers. Howard to the bottom, Bainey recovering, settles into fourth. Still a good day for Tim Bainey Jr.
A great solid run for Tim Bainey. I'm glad to see it. It's been a long time coming, and he certainly deserves it. What I was watching it from that in-car camera, these cars are bouncing around a lot. It's this shock spring package that they're running. They're so soft in the front, they've got them tied down, but those cars really bounce around, really working the tires hard to go across the bumps.
Well, there's Justin Hobgood, another Rookie of the Year contender in the Naturally Fresh Foods Ford. That's the 16.
He is the South Series 16 car, right in front of Brett Butler in the Aaron's Dream Machine. There's Trevor Bayne. He had gotten two laps down early, got one of them back, trying to get back on the lead lap. But Bayne stuck back in 30th. Here's Mike Kerman in the 34 car. He's shown 19th right now. And back on board, Brett Butler in the Aaron's Dream Machine, the 99th car. Rookie of the Year contender from the South
Series. Oh, right in front of you. Hang on.
Oh, Cassola goes around. Hobgood stands the 16 on its nose. Butler avoids trouble. We saw Kirk Leone spin there.
Great job by Brett Butler. The thing is, there's no time for the spotter to tell you. You better be watching in front of you. And he was. He was heavy in the brake pedal to keep out of that.
Dominic Cassola and the Cassola Farm 02 out of New Jersey goes around over in turn two here at Jennerstown. He spins the car around, refires it, may have a tire down, definitely has a left rear tire down on the 02. So Cassola will bring that car to pit road and try to get it ready for the final laps here today. And this may give some of the other cars that needed a stop an opportunity.
There'll be time for everybody to regroup just a little bit. As you watch this car go off into the corner, a little bit of contact right there with the 52 car. Wayne Willard on the outside, the 02 Cassola goes around. He's got a flat tire. Wow, how did everybody miss this?
A lot of contact, I would say, out of turn four. The 52 of Leone and Cassola and the 02 leaning on each other. All right, Tim Bainey was running fourth. He's going to stop in front of Brett.
Well, Tim Bainey held out as long as he could on those older tires, and now he's coming in for his pit stop. He should be able to go the rest of the way from this point. They're changing the right side, got the right front off. A little bit of trouble with that one, trying to get it off. Finally, they finish their work on the right side, come around to the left side, and they're going to change both tires on this side as well. Tim Bainey, nearby Jennerstown native, would love to come out of here with a win. Top five finish, something good to take home and celebrate with.
Woody Howard on pit road along with Mike Mason. There's Andrew Rogers completing his service. All of these cars should be ready to go to the checkered flag today. But before we go green again, let's remember one of the gentlemen for whom this championship series is named on the Hooters Pro Cup Tour. Charlie Campbell was the pilot of the flight that crashed, claiming the lives of Alan Kulwicki, Dan Duncan, Mark Brooks, and himself. He was a former Eastern Airlines pilot, very passionate about flying, with a deep love of music. But Charlie Campbell always had his family as his first love. A consummate professional, a devoted family man, Charlie Campbell will always be remembered as a champion. Back at Jennerstown, preparing for a restart. Riding here with Michael Rich, the naturally fresh camera inside the Jack Ruby Sauce's Ford. Rich up with the lead lap tires on the outside.
Well, I think everybody's kind of went through their cycle. They've got what they've got now. The only reason you're going to hit pit road is if you've got a problem. So, Michael Rich, we're racing.
Watch his hand on the right. Down into high gear. Green flag back in the air. Underway again at Jennerstown. Rich trying to roll to the outside. And Trevor Bayne. Bayne almost runs him up the racetrack into the marbles. Able to get around the 29 car.
Man, these are the places where you have one foot on the gas and one on the brake, and you're just working that traffic.
Clay Rogers is working hard meantime on Benny Gordon. These two have tangled many times. Two of the great championship contenders here in the USAR Hooters Pro Cup Series. Johnny Rumley's 80 car, the Junior Motorsports Chevy behind. A lot of us thought that Rumley would be a factor, but he got caught up in a wreck last night. And the car was badly damaged. They got him out to try to score some points today. But Rumley not a factor for the win. 102 laps to go.
Johnny Rumley got caught up in that wreck. He would have been a factor because he was the best race car in practice yesterday. He had a great race car.
Jack Bailey there and Randy Humphrey's 93 car. He's on the move behind Shelby Howard. There's Rumley on the Champion Spark Plugs 80. Grease Lightning running order, top of your screen. Jeff Agnew runs 15th. Mike Mason's made his stop now on the Awesome Awnings 8 car. He's back to 16th in front of Woody Howard. Bainey back there in 19th. Michelle Ferriel, Daniel Johnson. As we watch Bailey in the 93 car. A.J. Frank with him in the 11. And Mark Nesbitt is there as well.
Jack Bailey had to take a provisional. But yet he was one of the fastest cars at the end of that last run out on the racetrack, according to the computer, one of the best race cars on the racetrack. We've been waiting for Jack Bailey to really show what his stuff, because we've seen a lot of him during the season. I think he can be a contender for the championship.
Bailey in the Ferguson Waterworks 93. A.J. Frank there in car number 11. That's the J. Holden Construction Coastal Medical car. Ian Bailey putting on a great battle for position. Down into turn number one. Meantime, for the lead on the backstretch, Clay Rogers on the outside of Gordon. Rogers is going to try him on the high side. The Automotive Development Group Ford on the outside of the Predator Performance entry. Side by side into one. Gordon on the bottom. Rogers, good drive off the corner. Gordon able to maintain on the inside. Rogers will try to get him out of turn number four. Less than 100 to go. And Rogers, by a wheel width, leads lap 153. Gordon right back at him, though. Rogers giving Gordon room. Gives him lots of room that time. Car slips up the track a little bit.
Actually, the 44 car moved up a little bit. He wanted to get a better run off the corner. He accomplished that. Both of these guys are just simply riding for points. They're out there just for points, right?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Yeah, wow,
you
what a run.
You race that hard with 95 laps to go if you're racing for points, don't you?
What a run on the outside by the 44 car of Clay Rogers.
Gordon tries to come back at him on the bottom, but Rogers able to maintain the momentum up where he is. One car width off the bottom. Rogers takes the 44 to the inside in the corner and closes the door on Benny Gordon. So Clay Rogers, for the first time today, is the leader. 95 to go. On board with Shelby Howard. He is running third. Look at the gap between the 20 car and the two leaders.
Well, Shelby, all I tell you, just keep cruising, make laps, get there towards the end, because you may end up winning this thing. Those guys are fighting really hard up in front of you.
Shelby Howard with Johnny Rumley in tow. Rumley nowhere near the lead after all the damage done to the 80 car last night. Now Benny Gordon starting to reel Rogers back in. Now, does Gordon cool his tires, keep the car straight, and try to come back at Clay, or does he wait?
I think Benny Gordon's a little bit bewildered as, man, I've led all this thing. I sat on a pole. I had the best race car out here, and all of a sudden, this guy jumps in, passes you on the outside. You've got to really start second-guessing. What do I need to do to finish this thing off at the end of the race? Yes, I think you're exactly right. He's going to slow down and cool his tires.
A.J. Frank in that 11 car. Meantime, the J. Holden Construction entry, he's moved to fourth behind Shelby Howard. That's Martin Nesbitt one spot further back. Good run to fifth for Martin Nesbitt in the 88 North. Out of North Carolina, Shane Wallace there in the 38 car. He's on the move in the Shane Wallace Motorsports entry. And next in line is Michael Rich in the Jackaroo Sauces car. Wallace in sixth. And Michael Rich in seventh of the Jackaroo Meat Sauces car. As we ride inside the 28 car, naturally fresh camera there. Michael Rich having trouble keeping that car down on the inside.
Oh, I was just going to say, imagine this. Michael Rich running the second group at the racetrack, huh? He finds a way to get around every racetrack he goes to.
Jack Bailey there in the 93, Randy Humphrey's car. Gary St. Amant trying to come back in the Jags.com entry. Bailey running eighth. St. Amant is ninth. And then the 22 of Marty Lindley. It's the Black's Tire Service entry. He rounds out the top 10. Less than 90 to go. St. Amant had a sniff of the lead earlier, but he's got some wrinkles in that car on the left side now.
But they must have made a couple of adjustments, because his car is very, very quick right now out on the racetrack.
Justin Hobgood in the naturally fresh Germain 16 just worked his way around Marty Lindley, and the caution is out. Debris on the speedway. And it might have come off the car of Lonnie Rush. Rush back out on the racetrack there at the 71 after a hard wreck earlier. And you can see that piece of sheet metal just sticking out from the right side of the car. So, Clay Rogers took the lead away from Benny Gordon a few laps back. Rogers will be the restart pole sitter when we continue at Jennerstown Speedway. Back at Jennerstown Speedway, preparing for another restart, the Charlie Campbell Memorial Miller Lite 250. Second of six races in the championship series for the USAR Hooters Pro Cup Tour. And 2006. With Scott Sutherland, I'm Rick Benjamin. A lot of wrinkled up race cars. Most of the carnage last night when we ran 49 laps amidst the rain showers. Today, dry, cool, and crisp. October the 1st, fall is here in Western Pennsylvania. Safety car is in, ready to go. Clay Rogers, your restart leader in the 44, and we are back underway.
Down into the corner. Whoa!
Contact! Benny Gordon, Trevor Bayne tangling, going into turn one, and Gordon slams the wall in the Predator Performance Ford. Caution returns very quickly. We don't even get a lap in. Gordon got taken out there by Trevor Bayne.
You know, I don't know what happened. They both went down in the corner. You know, Trevor Bayne's trying to stay with the leaders to get back on the lead lap. And it's just hard to say if Trevor held his line or did he actually come up or who did what. But I'm telling you, that's a hard lick on the 66 car. And I'm glad to see. Yep, he's moving around inside the car, but that was a heck of a lick on the left-hand side of the race car.
Hey, you can see Benny Gordon try to refire the 66, and then he dropped the window net quickly. He's pulling the helmet off. Surprised he didn't try to roll the car backwards down the racetrack. He had it in gear and was bouncing off the concrete there when he tried to refire. But in any case, Gordon, we heard Brett McMillan tell us earlier, he knew he needed a good run, a good points finish to get back in contention after the trouble they had at Iowa Speedway. Now he's going to be taken out early again here at Jennerstown, his home racetrack, after starting on the pole.
That had to ring his bell, because when you hit with the left side that hard, your door bar stopped that race car so fast with that concrete, it really, really works on your headgear, and that had to ring his bell.
Trevor Bayne at age 15 out of Knoxville, Tennessee, being taken to the ambulance. He'll be taken to the infield care center. Benny Gordon will have to make the same trip. He'll do it on foot, evidently. One more look at what happened. The green had just reappeared.
Benny Gordon going in on the outside. Looks like Trevor Bayne locks the car up hard, and that's what made the contact. You can see his brakes are locked up all the way across. Benny Gordon with a vicious hit, and we'll take another angle of it as they go up in the corner. See the sparks fly underneath the 29 car. That sent him up into Benny Gordon. His car, the tires were locked up, and at that point, it was all over. A terrible break for both these guys, especially Benny Gordon.
Looked as though perhaps Bayne had a tire down. He certainly had all four wheels locked. And he went up the racetrack. Looks as though he went up and got into the side of Benny Gordon's Predator Performance Ford. Red flag is out. Gordon walks up into the hauler. Miller Lite Rookie of the Year standings. Bayne led coming in here after the Iowa Championship race. Hobgood, Derek Cale, Danji Hannaford, and Jim Crabtree, the first five in Miller Lite Rookie of the Year standings. Now, where they're running right now, with 83 laps to go, Hobgood is first among the rookie class. Butler, Derek Cale, Mike Mason, and Jim Crabtree, and we're assuming that Trevor Bayne will not be back as we are under a red flag here at Jennerstown Speedway. While we have the opportunity, my buddy Scott Sutherland has another tech tip for us this afternoon.
As you see these race cars rocket down the straightaway, they got to do one thing when they get to the other end, and that's stop. Check this out. This is a passenger car brake pad. This is a race car brake pad. This is the brand new Hawk DTC70, dynamic torque control. What that means is, as you see these cars go off in the corner, the rotors are burning bright red. You still got to be able to stop the car, and that's what these are so good at. When you first hit the brake pedal, the car drops, and you can stay on that brake all the way into the corner and get it slowed down. Even though it's bright red, that car is still going to stop and be under control. Very key when you're driving these type of race cars, heavy as they are. They have a complete line for every racing application, as well as your street car at home.
Series. I'm Rick Benjamin with Scott Sutherland. Time now for our Lucas Oil race recap at halfway. Green flag waving last night under threatening skies. First 49 laps would go on the board here on Saturday night. Bobby Gill caught up in an early skirmish. The USD Sheetrock car suffering significant front end damage. 19 laps on the board. Johnny Rumley got into some oil, a blown motor from Danji Hannaford's car. Matt Carter, Jody Lavender caught up in it. And on lap 49, the red flag had to come out. That would be the end of action on Saturday night. We restarted this afternoon on lap 56. Benny Gordon had the restart pole. Clay Rogers right behind him in the 44 car. A couple of laps later, out of turn two, contact between Trevor Bayne and Sam Pallone. Bayne would go around and lose two laps. 76 laps on the board. caution had already waved. Lonnie Rush got punted, got up into the wall and hit it pretty hard. On lap 95, J.J. Pack and the 72 of Gary Santamacchia together. On lap 153 for the lead on the outside, Clay Rogers able to drive around the defending series champion, Benny Gordon. Now just a few laps later, Gordon's afternoon would come to an early end. He and Trevor Bayhn get together in turn one. Both the 66 and the 29 hard trips into the concrete. They are done for the day, and that's your Lucas Oil race recap. So now Clay Rogers will have the restart pole, and he won't have his mirrors full with the defending champ.
And I think Clay Rogers, this whole thing just changed tremendously. You just sit there and you ride. If the wind comes, that's great. Right now you're thinking about points. You've really got to concentrate on points. You go back to that little bitty wreck, that sure changed the complexity of this race.
All right, we will be back for the restart at Jennerstown in just a moment. Jennerstown getting set for another restart in the Charlie Campbell Memorial Miller Lite 250. On board here with Shelby Howard. He's been quick. He's won here before. What do you think? Can Clay Rogers hold off Howard?
I think Clay Rogers has to go right back to the same thing, and that's try to win a championship. Think about points. This 20 car gets alongside. You don't want to get into trade and paint. You want to think about the big picture. But I think he's got a good enough horse to stay in front.
Rogers will lead them out of turn number four here at Jennerstown Speedway. Sam Filone's Perro's Vegetables car on the inside could not get the lap back. Green back in the air, and here we go. 75 laps to go. A.J. Frank sits third. Pepsi running order, top of your screen. Bobby Gill stuck back there in 30th. Rumley, 32nd. Lavender and Lonnie Rush. Eric Corbett didn't take the green here this afternoon. Joey Logano knocked out last night along with Dan Hannaford. Some of the drivers we thought would be prime contenders here and in the entire championship series. And when you only have six races to fight it out for the title, every race counts even more than normal.
A little mistake becomes a great big mistake, and that's why it's so important to just finish these races.
Rogers by five car lengths over Shelby Howard. Frank is third. Mark Nesbitt, the ConstructionJobs.com car. Out of North Carolina, good run for him in fourth. Jim Crabtree Jr. there, one of the Rookie of the Year contenders, shown 22nd right now. Crabtree in the McCreary County Funeral Home Chevrolet. There is Nesbitt in that ConstructionJobs.com car.
Very impressive. Martin Nesbitt's really just kind of quietly positioned himself in the four spot. And you know what? He's holding his own. He's got a good race car here today. Haven't had a chance to really talk about him much, but I like what he's doing.
Shane Wallace, meantime, started 16th last night. He's rolled the Shane Wallace Motorsports entry up nicely inside the top 10. In front of Michael Ricks. Let's get on board the Jackaroo Meat Sauces car. Ricks takes a look to the outside. That's usually where he likes to run.
Well, you knew that car was going to end up there. He thought he'd kind of move to the bottom, maybe fake him out just a little bit. Shane Wallace it is, and then roll to the outside and drive on by.
Jack Bailey back there in the 93, Randy Humphrey's car. Benny Gordon done for the afternoon. The defending series champ behind the wall. He's got to be very disappointed at what he considers his home racetrack. Right, Brett?
Benny looked a little shaky. How you feeling?
I got my bell rung a little bit. It was pretty good lick down there. Car was awesome. Performance car was awesome. I think it was going to be a great race between Clay and I, and that's what this championship series is all about, great racing like that. I hate to see myself or him get knocked out of it this way. But I don't know what happened. Lap car got up into the side of us, I think. I can't really say one way or the other, but that's what I'm hearing. And hit me really hard and just spun me around backwards into the fence. So took us out of the contentions. We led the most laps, led halfway, everything, doing everything we needed to do. Just a bad day for the performance sport.
He was trying to get to the end of this race with a good finish. I think finishing second would have been okay. That would have put him back in contention for the championship.
But that Predator Performance team, they've dug themselves a big hole. A couple of tough finishes in the first two of the six championship races. Meantime, Shane Wallace, Michael Rich, Jack Bailey in the 93 car, all running nose to tail here as they fight it out for fifth, sixth, and seventh. Michael Rich cannot keep the 28 down on the inside. Now, we talk about how he likes to run high a lot of times, but here at Jennerstown, that's not the quick way around.
No, I think you've got to use the bottom. That makes a bigger circle out of the racetrack. However, Michael just likes to use the top of the racetrack. About every place we go, he can get a good run off the corner. Jack Bailey really using the bottom, can roll the middle pretty fast.
They got about 65 laps to go. Jeff Fultz in trouble, and the CNC Boilers 54 down on the inside. AJ Frank, meantime, good run for that young driver. Out of the North Series, currently shown in third. Frank in the J. Holden Construction Pontiac. Trying to hold back Martin Nesbitt, about six car lengths the gap there. And you've got Wallace, Rich, and Bailey. Gary St. Amant hanging on an eighth in front of Justin Hobgood. Wayne Willard rounds out the first 10 in the Bowen Holmes car.
Martin Nesbitt really rolls that car into the corner. It rolls in and through the middle very quick. He gives up just a little bit off the corner to the 11 car.
There's Shane Wallace's Ford. Still looking for his first career win. Thought he had one a couple of times this season. Could not close the deal. But he has been fast week in and week out. Nesbitt in the 88. He's been to Victory Lane a couple of years ago at South Boston. Mark Nesbitt in fourth and starting to reel in the third place car of A.J. Frank. Shelby Howard sits second, trying to get close and mount a challenge on Clay Rogers. Benny Gordon, meantime, his championship hopes may have ended right here. He and Trevor Bayne hard into the concrete just a few moments ago. We'll be back at Jennerstown. We are back at Jennerstown Sunday afternoon. We're in overtime. This one started Saturday night. Didn't quite get to the 50-lap mark before rains brought out the red flag. Restarted this afternoon. Lots of action here at Jennerstown. Less than 60 laps to go. Mike Herman in the 34, the Fireside Hearth and Homes entry. Battling there with young Mike Mason in the Awesome Awnings 8 car. The Premier Motorsports entry. First ride for Mason. Rookie contender out of Bakersfield, California. Ran most of the year in the family-owned 75 car. End of the season, got around. They were pretty much out of equipment. And then Mike Mason picked up the ride in that 8, and he has given it a good run here today at Jennerstown. Woody Howard, the surprise winner at the Iowa Speedway a couple of weeks ago to open up the championship series. That's the Dean Motorsports Joe Gibbs Oil Chevrolet. He's right there behind Mason. BF Goodrich running order, top of your screen. Show you where all these contenders are now on the lead lap as they fight for position. Wayne Willard rounds out the first 10 of the Bowen Holmes entry. Red Butler and Tim Bainey, Derek Cale, 13th spot, Agnew 14th, and Mason 15th. Andrew Rogers trying to work to the inside there of the 34 of Mike Herman. Rogers in that Termidor Aaron's Pontiac out of Indian Trail, North Carolina. There's Mason in the 8, Howard in the 55. Mike Herman dragging the brakes in the 34 going down into the corner there. Slips up the track, and that lets Rogers move by. Marty Lindley right in the mix as well in the 22. That's the Black's Tire Service entry. Jay Fogelman, the Grease Lightning 4, to the inside of Herman. Good battling for position here.
And not only here, but all the way around the racetrack. There's groups of cars racing everywhere. This long stretch of green, your race car changes. About every 10 laps, it'll do something just a little bit different, especially depending on what line you're in and how you're using the brakes. So you got to keep adjusting constantly.
All these drivers running 15th, 16th, 17th, and 18th, and they're on a little different pit stop sequence than the leaders.
Yeah, and you would think they'd have a little bit of an advantage because of tire wear. However, the tires are so good at this racetrack. At this point in time, I don't think that's just thrown out the window. It's just a matter of track position at this point.
Race leader is Clay Rogers. He's got Shelby Howard in tow, and they're working their way through these slower cars. Dominic Casola will move over in the Casola Farms 02. Let the leaders go by with no problems. On board the Lucas Oil Camera today inside the Speedco 20, young Shelby Howard out of Indiana. And he has tucked right up on the rear bumper of Clay Rogers now in turn 3. Out of turn 4, Jeff Agnew there battling with Derek Cale and Brett Butler. Trevor Bayne involved in that hard wreck with Benny Gordon. He's standing by with Brett.
Well, Trevor, first of all, are you okay? That was a pretty good lick.
Yeah, that was one of the hardest hits I've ever had. You know, it's just, that was crazy.
Any idea what happened?
I went into the corner racing to get my lap back. I already got one back. And I guess, you know, Benny thinking that I'm a lap car, he can, you know, come down and I'm going to lift. But we're racing that hard out there. I just can't, you know, lock up the brakes or whatever and let him come to the bottom. You know, they might think it's my fault, but I definitely don't think it was, because I was all the way at the bottom of the racetrack when we made contact. And then as soon as we touch, it's just like being on ice. The tires lock up and you hit the brakes and it's no good. You know, they just slide all the way to the wall. So, I mean, there was nothing I could do about it once we made contact.
Well, I think if Trevor Bayne sees that replay, he might see it a little differently, Scott.
Well, he went in pretty fast on the bottom, but there again, I think he was anticipating the 66 to stay up and give him that groove on the bottom, and he was going to try to stay with Benny Gordon. And try, if he could get past him, he can run down the 44, but you've got to do first things first.
Well, as you pointed out, he may have had the wrong entry, the wrong arc into the corner. He was tucked in on the inside and really couldn't turn the car down there.
Well, he was pretty low, and he was coming in pretty hot. But the thing is, you're trying to race hard as you can. That is your job as a driver. And he was doing everything he could to try to get back on that lead lap.
Martin Nesbitt in the 88 starting to close in on Frank for third. Less than 50 to go at Jennerstown. This one in the hands of Clay Rogers in the Automotive Development Group 44. The Speedco, Tony Stewart Motorsports Pontiac of Shelby. Howard runs second. Howard, I like the way he's being patient here. Second about three car lengths back. All right, let's take a quick break, and we'll be right back with more at Jennerstown Speedway. Welcome back to Jennerstown with Scott Sutherland, Nymerick Benjamin, the Charlie Campbell Memorial Miller Lite 250. Second of six championship races to decide the 2006 USAR Hooters Pro Cup Series title. Garrett Cale in the 22, one of the Rookie of the Year contenders. Right in front of Jeff Agnew, a former national champion on this tour. Mark IV Honda 73 car. Lucas Oil running order, top of your screen. Cale trying to fend off the 73 as they battle for 11th. Cale with that Girty Engines logo on the hood. That's a Laughlin chassis car. Heritage equipment on the side of that 22 car for the rookie contender. Agnew rolls by on the outside. Here comes Woody Howard. Joe Gibbs Oil 55. iCard running order, top of your screen. iCard, the official timing and scoring provider of the USAR Hooters Pro Cup Series.
Gary St. Amant has climbed himself up to fifth place. A very good race car, very fast right now this part of the race. He's got something if he can get there. It's just that I don't know if he has enough time. Track position is killing him.
Clay Rogers the leader, lapping by Andrew Rogers there in the Termidor. Aaron's 18. Jay Fogelman in the four car. Jay told me before the start, wanted to say hello to Craig LaPointe, the marketing manager of Grease Lightning. Had to miss today's event. Got married this weekend. He and his wife Jennifer off on their honeymoon. Trouble up the racetrack. Andrew Rogers gets way high up in the marbles, keeps it off the wall as Clay Rogers, no relation, continues to lead in the 44. He is closing in on Mike Mason in the Awesome Awnings 8. Steve Husketh's car. Steve battling back. He has been under the weather much of the season, fighting cancer. Wish Steve all the best. Up onto the back straightaway. Oh, and Rogers on the brakes. Caution on the speedway. Oh, contact back there. Andrew Rogers runs into the back end of the four car of Jay Fogelman. Debris on the speedway. The yellow was waving. I don't think Andrew Rogers saw the yellow lights come on.
Well, they're another case of everybody slowing down. Andrew Rogers was wide open coming up off the corner. Just couldn't get slowed down in time. Got into the back of the four car of Jay Fogelman and sent him into the outside wall. Andrew Rogers hit the wall himself. Wow.
Both of those cars with severe damage to the front end sections. Doesn't look as though the radiators are broken. We don't see any fluid on the racetrack. Andrew Rogers will bring the 18 car around to pit road. Fogelman will have to pit the 4 car, the Grease Lightning entry. So, tough way to enter the final 30 laps here at Jennerstown when you get into the wall hard like that on the backside. And both of those cars sustaining heavy, heavy damage. So the caution waves again. Now here's Fogelman in the Grease Lightning Ford out of North Carolina. Coming to the attention of his crew. They will try to straighten out the sheet metal. Andrew Rogers in the Termidor 18 really sustained some front end damage. Looks as though a lot of things were moved around on that car. Fogelman's team is trying to pull away the loose bodywork there.
And that's the best thing they can do right now is get everything off from in front of the radiator, try to get it off the tires, let him finish this race, and try to pick up as many positions or keep as many as he can. But what a way to end the day. And we've seen a lot of cars out here that just look like they've been through a demolition derby.
Well, you can see a lot of marbles up on the high side of the racetrack there. It's pretty tough to navigate here at Jennerstown. You've got to take into account the condition of the racetrack, certainly, as we get down to the last couple of dozen laps. Field getting the one to go sign. Clay Rogers, Shelby Howard, and A.J. Frank will be the first three. Martin Nesbitt will line up fourth. Four races to go to settle the 2006 championship of the Hooters Pro Cup Series. October 14th at Mansfield in Ohio, Myrtle Beach on the 28th, then to South Georgia Motorsports Park November 11th. The traditional Thanksgiving weekend closer November 25th at USA International in Lakeland. So four more races, four opportunities for you to get tickets. Come on out and support your favorite Hooters Pro Cup cars and drivers. Ready to restart once again at Jennerstown. The Fatheads.com safety car on pit road. Clay Rogers has been the dominant force since Benny Gordon went out in that tangle with Trevor Bayne. Green back in the air. And Rogers takes him down into one. Good lead over Shelby Howard. Marty Lindley gets up in front of Howard. He wanted to get his lap back. He's got to track down Rogers now to do that. Marty Lindley's won races here in the past.
I think you'll see Marty Lindley drive really hard, try to catch Clay Rogers. If he can't get his lap back, he'll let the leaders go. He's not going to be one that's going to be in the middle of this thing and kind of mess everybody else up.
32 laps remain. Miller Lite running order, top of your screen. Gary Saint-Amant, very nice run for the Jakes.com Chevrolet driver. He is fifth right now.
Well, how about this? A.J. Frank got by Shelby Howard on that last restart. Got a good run down in the corner. A.J. Frank now second.
Field up out of turn number two. Lap traffic very much a factor here. Michael Rich in the 28 car. There's Saint-Amant. He's right up behind Martin Nesbitt now. A.J. Frank, as Scott pointed out, getting around Howard. Nesbitt starting to track down Shelby Howard, who may be out of tires. Brad McMillan, what about Martin Nesbitt's story?
You guys know that a lot of times the driver will tell you that they know more than the crew chief does. And, well, sometimes that's the case, but not always. In Martin Nesbitt's case, though, it may well, in fact, be the case. I asked the guys in the pits, who's your crew chief today? They said, he's sitting in the car. He's calling all the shots today, and right now has his best run of the year going.
Well, a lot of times that's the way it has to happen, because a driver will listen to his race car to make the changes. And as long as you've got a couple guys that really understand what's going on during the race, you're okay. A lot of times a crew chief with young drivers, they can't make the decision. The crew chief has to. Martin Nesbitt has been doing this for a long time as a crew chief and a driver, and he can make those decisions.
Tough thing to do, though, to combine all three jobs. Team owner, driver, and crew chief, Martin Nesbitt. Great day going. There's the 22, the Black Tire Service car. Marty Lindley, one on the tour this season after jumping into that race car, currently scored 15th, one lap down to the leader.
Looks like A.J. Frank is actually gaining on the 44 car of Clay Rogers. His car may be just a little bit quicker right now.
Frank in second spot. These two cars pitted right before the 80 lap mark. Rogers in that Baird Transport Johnny Suzuki 44. Former series champion 2 years ago. Frank and Rogers used to work together on these race cars. Frank closing the gap on the leader in the 11. A.J. Frank, what a story this would be. Rogers, I'm sure, thought that once Benny Gordon went out on the hook, he had clear sailing to victory lane.
And his car really goes down into the corners fast. He gains a lot of ground going into the corner. He can kind of maintain off the exit. So right now, his car just a little bit quicker than the 44 car.
Frank and the J. Holden Construction Pontiac, less than 25 laps to go this afternoon at Jennerstown. Justin Hobgood closes out the first 10 right in front of Derek Cale. They will lap by the four, the wounded machine of Jay Fogelman, the Grease Lightning Four. Lots of stuff hanging off every part of that four car, but Fogelman wants to get to the checkered flag. Frank now, two car lengths back of the leader, down into turn three. A.J. Frank trying to turn up the wick on Clay Rogers.
Well, I know A.J. Frank and Clay Rogers, they're buddies. But if you can get your bumper close enough, do you go ahead and give him that love tap? A.J. Frank wants to win a race real bad.
Oh, yellow again. Caution again on the speedway. Mike Kerman has spun the fireside hearth at home. Chevy on the backstretch. It's our 11th caution of the afternoon, 21 laps to go. saw the 34 car tucked against the inside wall as the leaders raced by there a moment ago. Mike Herbert trying to refire the Fireside Chevy. And he will get it going and pointed in the right direction. So Herman will prepare for the restart. Clay Rogers will have the point when we come back at Jennerstown Speedway. We are back at Jennerstown on a beautiful fall Sunday afternoon. Second race of the USAR Hooters Pro Cup Championship Series in 2006. And the car that was running second stopping on the backstretch. What's happened to A.J. Frank?
The engine is not running. There's no way that car could have ran out of fuel. Is there?
Wouldn't think so. He stopped with Clay Rogers and several of the other leaders.
Sometimes in your haste to get a great pit stop, to get the four tires on, to get the car off pit road, it's possible they didn't get all the fuel in that car. If you're trying to do a fast pit stop, this would be a heartbreaker if this car ran out of fuel.
Well, the Jennerstown safety crew on the scene with their dune buggy to push Frank, try to get him around to pit road, but he may lose a lap here. Tough break for the young driver out of the North Series who was running second to Clay Rogers. This will cost him a shot at a top five.
And not only was he running second, I think he was just a little bit quicker than the 44. Now, catching the 44 was one thing, and passing him is another. But if you're in contention, man, that is a great feeling.
Well, the J. Holden Construction Pontiac rolls down on pit road. A.J. Frank's crew ready to service that car and try to get him back out, Brett.
Well, A.J. Frank has come to a stop at his pit stall, and the car is not running at all. And they are absolutely out of gas. Try to get it refired, and so far, absolutely no look. The crew is now pushing it down. Finally. No, not yet. It stalls off. They're still trying to get that car refired. What a devastating turn of events for A.J. Frank and his crew. Running in second, and they run out of gas.
And they're spraying ether down into the air cleaner to try to get that thing to fire. They can spin over, they can get it to fire, and try to pull the fuel up from the fuel cell with the fuel pump to the carburetor. It takes a long time to do that. Hey, they didn't lose a lap. They're back out with the lead lap cars, but wow, track position.
A.J. Frank with a couple of dozen laps to go here at Jennerstown. We'll have to restart at the end of the longest line of lead lap cars.
We thought with all the caution laps we'd run that fuel would not be a problem for anybody. But now that one's already ran out, there may be a lot of guys up here thinking, hey, how much fuel do I have in my race car? And is it a concern? Guys that made pit stops back on lap 78, Clay Rogers, Shelby Howard, Jeff Agnew, and yes, Martin Nesbitt. There's a four of you guys up front that still have that worry. Am I going to make it to the end?
Yeah. Well, this will put A.J. Frank back in about 14th spot, right behind Shane Wallace. Restart leader again is Clay Rogers. Kirk Leon on the inside. He'll hope to get a lap back in the 52. He has nothing, though, for Rogers. Green back in the air. 14 laps to go to settle things here at Jennerstown. Shelby Howard is second, and Rogers pulls away from the 20 car. Leon moves up the racetrack and tucks in behind, in front of Martin Nesbitt, who runs third. Gary St. Amant back there battling for fourth. Michael Rich is right there as well, and Wayne Willard. But Rogers in that Johnny Suzuki car, boy, is he quick here.
Car really jumping up off the corner. It looks as though his car is really good on restarts. Really jumps off the corner. It may slow down after 20 laps, just a tick. But he's got a really good hot rod. I think he set himself up for the end. You can't say enough about Martin Nesbitt, though. What a day he's had.
That car has really reacted well to the change from nighttime conditions last night to the sunshine we've had much of the afternoon here. The Longhorn running order, 13 laps to go. There's Nesbitt in third, St. Amant. Michael Rich has gotten himself back into contention, as has Jeff Agnew, Justin Hobgood, Kale in ninth, and Woody Howard. After a cut tire last night, he's in 10th. Nesbitt racing here with Kirk Leon, who's not on the lead lap in the 52.
And Leon's got to give way, let these guys go for it. They're going, getting down to inside the top 10. They've got to be able to race hard. How about the 72 car? He was involved in that spin earlier in the race. Had to make that pit stop, pull all that sheet metal, get four tires on it. That's a good race car.
Gary St. Amant is as good a long-distance stock car racer as you will find. Very patient, doesn't worry if he gets a lap down even. He knows the game is to be in contention in the last 30 laps.
Taking care of your equipment has a lot to do with long-distance racing. Gary St. Amant, one of the best at doing that.
Nesbitt, St. Amant, then the 52 car lap down, and Michael Rich and St. Amant. The Jakes.com Chevy up the racetrack again. That car's been tight, evidently, much of the day.
Well, he's trying to find a different groove that he can take advantage of, try to make a move on Martin Nesbitt. He just can't really find anything. He's a little bit quicker right through the middle. He can roll up to him, but there again, you've got to be able to pass him.
The Jackaroo sauce is 28 of Rich. There's the gap between Nesbitt and St. Amant. Third back to fourth. A little further back, Agnew and Marty Lindley. Looks like the Bowen Holmes car, Wayne Willard's machine, off the pace. He may have gotten up into the wall. And Brett Butler has spun. He's got problems again in the Aaron's Dream Machine, the 99 car, the Michael Waltrip Pontiac. Eight to go, and it's our 12th caution of the Charlie Campbell Memorial Miller Lite 250. One more look. Oh, and Willard got right up in the wall over there in turn two. Came down the racetrack, and Butler got on the brakes and went around, evidently, trying to avoid him.
There was a little bit of contact, sent Wayne Willard up the racetrack and got into the fence. Once you get into the marbles, there's no way you're going to recover.
All right, winding down to the final few laps at Jennerstown. Rogers, Howard, and Nesbitt, the top three. We'll be back. We are back at Jennerstown Speedway, the Charlie Campbell Memorial Miller Lite 250. Wheeland Light Bar is out on top of the Fatheads.com pace car. A look at Jack Bailey and Randy Humphrey's 93 car. In front of Jeff Agnew getting set for the restart. There's Cale and Woody Howard. Shelby Howard in that Speed Code 20 car. Right behind the Automotive Development Group 44 of Clay Rogers. Martin Nesbitt in the ConstructionJobs.com 88. He'll line up third in front of Gary St. Amant. Green flag back in the air at Jennerstown. Just a couple of laps to go to settle things. In fact, five to go. Brett McMillan, what about fuel mileage for the two lead cars?
Well, the 11 did run out of fuel. I talked about the 44 and the 20, and they say that fuel should be no problem for them.
A couple of miles to go until we see the checkered flag today at Jennerstown Speedway. And Clay Rogers doing, oh, trouble.
Oh!
Mike Mason slides down the front straightaway in the Awesome Awnings 8 car. Might have been some contact with A.J. Frank in the 11 North. Mason keeps it off the wall, but I suspect we will see the yellow once again.
Come up off the corner, got a little bit loose, and maybe just grazed the wall a little bit on the outside. Started headed back down across the racetrack, a little bit of contact with the 11, sent him down, and how he kept it off the wall to me is amazing.
Looked as though he was headed for the outside concrete right under the flag stand there, and somehow the young driver from Bakersfield, California, college student at the University of North Carolina at Charlotte, avoided pounding that wall. Brings the Premier Motorsports Ford, the Awesome Awnings car, to a stop. And he has got the car refired. Then I think he stalled it, trying to get it back into gear and get the car around so he can complete the show here this afternoon at Jennerstown Speedway. There's the UMG Financial 16 of J.J. Pack up in the top five earlier today. Rest of the field funneling by on the inside. Jeff Agnew, he's got a problem in that Mark IV Honda car. He may be out of fuel.
So here's the deal. These cars going around the racetrack, they got the pickup tube on the right-hand side of the fuel cell. They've got to keep up to speed, some speed, to keep the fuel crushed over to the right-hand side. What happens is when they're going slow with the banking, the fuel goes to the left-hand side. They can't get it picked up. You got to keep weaving the car back and forth, and then you can get enough fuel. But Jeff Agnew must be really low in order for it not to pick up.
So again, the Jennerstown Dune Buggy comes out to help the Ford Fusion of Jeff Agnew. And Agnew out of Virginia will get pushed around onto pit road. They'll throw a couple of gallons of fuel in the 73 car and get him back out for the final couple of laps here today at Jennerstown Speedway. A couple of weeks, we go to Mansfield Motorsports Park in Ohio for the third of the championship races that will decide the USIR Hooters Pro Cup title. Again, a look at the drivers who pitted back on lap 78. Agnew was among those cars that pitted a long, long time ago now. Your leader, Clay Rogers, still out there. What about the 20 car, Brett McMillan?
How do you feel about your guys' chances of getting by that 44?
I don't know. Clay's awful strong. Shelby's doing a great job. It'll just come down to the end here. It'll probably come down to a green-white checker, and as you know, anything can happen when that happens.
If Clay Rogers does the same thing he's done in the last few restarts, he'll get a great jump, but he's got to make sure he gets it in gear.
Shelby Howard will try everything in the book to take the win here at Jennerstown. Right. We're back at Jennerstown Speedway preparing for a restart. A couple of laps to go today in the Charlie Gamble Memorial Miller Lite 250, second of the championship races here in 2006. I'm Rick Benjamin with Scott Sutherland. They've refueled the 73. Jeff Agnew will come around and take up his place in the restart running order.
Well, we started out on Saturday. We're going to Sunday. Who would guess we're going to be in overtime, huh? The only fitting for the whole thing.
Eddie Kelly mentioned it a moment ago on lap 252. It'll be a green-white checkered finish to settle things. Rogers under the green flag once again and again gets a good jump. Third is Nesbitt. Fourth spot belongs to St. Amant. Michael Rich is fifth. White flag this time by, and Shelby Howard can't do anything with Clay Rogers.
Shelby Howard wanted to stay with him, at least for that first corner, to have an opportunity. Clay Rogers says, no chance.
White flag is in the air. The battle now is for the positions behind Clay Rogers. Howard tried to hang on to second. Third belongs to Nesbitt. Gary St. Amant took a run at Nesbitt last time around, but everybody single file, and Clay Rogers headed to victory lane here at Jennerstown Speedway. Rogers takes the victory in the Charlie Campbell Memorial Miller Lite 250. Second spot to Shelby Howard. Third today goes to Mark Nesbitt. Gary St. Amant takes credit for fourth. Great run for the Automotive Development Group team and driver Clay Rogers.
They had a really good race car all day long. They set themselves up. When they went around Benny Gordon, when he passed Benny Gordon, he showed that he had the best race car on the racetrack. Now, could Benny Gordon come back? We don't know, but we do know one thing. This was a very good race car all day.
Well, there were so many cautions, 13 of them, in fact, and Rogers was able to stay out of trouble last night and again all day today. That's one of the keys to success in this series.
One of the few cars without dents down the side of it, for sure. Yeah. But there was a whole sigh of relief when that checkered flag finally fell. A lot of teams, a lot of drivers, and a lot of crew members finally said, thank goodness this baby's over.
Well, Clay Rogers will take the checkered flag and the reverse victory lap in honor of the late Alan Kulwicki and the rest of the champions who were honored during the USAR Hooters Pro Cup Championship Series. Rogers stakes his claim to the championship lead with four races to go here in 2006. In fact, unofficially, his points lead more than 80 now over Woody Howard. Rest of the field rolling down onto pit road. A lot of the cars among the walking wounded. But Clay Rogers was a dominant player at Jennerstown.
And out of the car he comes, Clay Rogers. Oh, yeah. He's going to celebrate big time in this one. Hop on down here, buddy. You have exercised your demons here at Jennerstown. Congratulations.
I couldn't be prouder of this race team. This is we've overcame our two worst racetracks this year, Myrtle Beach and here finally. We've put in a hard 4 days up here fighting the rain, and everybody has. And I hated to see what happened to Benny there. I mean, it was a good day for us in the points, but that's just not what, that's not how we wanted to win it. We wanted to race him, and I know those guys are upset, but the shoe could be on the other foot as well next week. But first and foremost, I want to say hey to Julie Lusk. She received some very bad news this past week, and sorry we hadn't been able to be home this week to support her and say hey to my brother and his girlfriend at home. Know they got a lot going on right now, but this race team, Automotive Development Group, Automotive Specialists, Bear Transport, Johnny Suzuki, all those guys that stuck behind us all year, Schaefer's Oil. We just got to race smart, and that's what we did today. And it was scary there at the end. It didn't seem like it was going to work out for us because we had a bad vibration right there at the end of the race, last 20, 30 laps. The only comfort we had was a couple other people were feeling it too. So don't know what the deal was there, but we'll go home, do our homework, try to figure it out. And where do we go next? Mansfield, I feel like we've got a good car for there. And we just got to be smart and keep our heads screwed on straight. And I can't do anything stupid on the racetrack.
Well, you told me before the race that if you leave here with a points lead, everybody else is in trouble. As long as you guys race smart, you still believe that?
Absolutely. I mean, a lot of people have had trouble. I've been in that position as well a couple years ago. But, at the end of the year, as long as I can stand at that table, no matter what table we're at, as long as I don't say if I hadn't have done something stupid, I'd be at the number one table. And that's my main concern right now. Blake Bamers and these guys keep putting fast race cars underneath me. Makes them easy to drive smart.
Win number 5 of the year for Clay Rogers and the first here at Jennerstown.
Out of all the racetracks that are left, this is the one he liked the least. Boy, I hate to see the rest of the shows, huh?
Well, with Shane Huffman up in the NASCAR Busch Series and Benny Gordon having problems today, Rogers has really staked a claim for the championship, I think, here in 2006. Howard second, Nesbitt, St. Amant, and Rich. Jeff Agnew has to settle for 11th.
Wayne Willard comes in 12th after a couple skirmishes. Woody Howard, Leon, Marty Lindley, J.J. Pack, all the way down. Mike Mason with a great run, just a little bit of a problem there at the end.
Brett Butler had trouble late in the race, ends up 21st in front of Michelle Theriault. Then Casola, Mike Kerman, and Jay Fogelman. Daniel Johnson second in Iowa, 26th today in front of Bobby Gill. Jeff Fultz, Gordon back there in 32nd.
And Trevor Bain as well in the back. Lonnie Rush, Matt Carter. How about Joey Logano, Danji Hanford, and Eric Corbett out of the race last night?
Those drivers certainly, their championship hopes suffering a severe blow here today. Back to Brett McMillan.
Well, Shelby, you came in here with high hopes, and by gosh, it paid off for you. Good second place run for you.
Yeah, it was pretty good. You know, we only got about 30 minutes of practice in. All these other guys came here and tested. So, you know, I was pretty happy, as good as the car was driving for that amount of practice. And, you know, right there at the end of the race, Clay had a good car, but we were having problems with the ignitions in the car, and it cut off, and we flipped back on, and I was having trouble keeping the car running, and, you know, coming out here with second place is good for us.
And whenever you talk about a good second place run in the championship series, that is important.
All the little things that go on inside a race car when you're trying to make a run, he points a lot of them out. But what a driver has to do besides just hold that steering wheel.
But we saw Rogers take off on the restarts. That may have been why Shelby Howard couldn't stay with him. Aaron Sard Charger Award to Jack Bailey. Picks up 31 spots from last night to today. Our Grease Lightning Super Strength Performer Award to Benny Gordon. He led 108 laps through 5 lead changes before getting caught up in a wreck.
Amart, I asked the guys in the pits, who was crewing today? They said he's sitting in the car. You're pretty good at that.
Well, I don't know about that. It was a team effort. We were running two cars this year, stretched a little thin. And when you've been doing as long as I have, you know too much, usually shoot yourself in the foot. But we just went with basics today. I got a great spotter in the spotter stand, and all the guys, we've been together a long time, and you know, it just feels good to run again. Got constructionjobs.com on board for the rest of the year, and really thrilled to get them some coverage. We struggled the middle of the year bad. It was so bad, it was probably the worst year of my career. Quit in the middle of the year and tried to get our act back together, and went out and recruited us some pit crew members, and we held our own this week on pit road when all of us came down pit road, and that was the difference to where we could run up front. And you know, it's just so critical here. If you don't have track position, you might as well go home. So thrilled for them, and looking forward to Mansfield.
I'll bet, after a third place finish here at Jennerstown.
Great to see Mark getting an opportunity to drive that race car and be competitive. And he makes a great point. Track position means everything. You can be 20th or you can be third and have the same race car.
Well, Justin Hobgood cashes in big here today. He takes the Miller Lite Rookie of the Year lead after two Championship Series races. Trevor Bain led coming in here today. Got caught up in that wreck with Benny Gordon. He drops to third. Miller Lite Rookie of the Race is Justin Hobgood, who gains 21 spots this afternoon. He's with Brett.
Well, Justin, second week in a row, you're the Rookie of the Race. Congratulations.
Well, thank you, sir. You know, it's just a testament to this team and Naturally Fresh, all our sponsors, Jermaine. Just everybody pulled together. I mean, I'm just one man, you know. I mean, these guys never give up. I mean, we stunk last night. I hit the wall with the car, bent the lower ball joints, and we come through and had a good run.
It was a long weekend, but worth it, huh?
Yeah, very worth it. Happy to be here.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Justin Hobgood really starting to figure this out now in Haskell Willingham's Naturally Fresh Fruits car. And he's 10th in the championship, right behind Mark Nesbitt, who is 9th. But the big number, Clay Rogers with an 81-point lead as we get set to go to Mansfield.
And that may be just enough of a safe margin for him to ride the rest of this year out.
Myrtle Beach, then South Georgia, and USA International to close the season. Next up for us, Mansfield Motorsports Speedway. Race time is 6 o'clock on Saturday, October 14th. We'll have the coverage for you on Wednesday, starting at 4 o'clock Eastern time from Mansfield. Well, it was certainly a wild Miller Lite 250 Charlie Campbell Memorial Run here at Jennerstown Speedway. All the motorsports news you need 24/7. Website is speedtv.com. Hooters Pro Cup Series racing information is available too at usarprocup.com. Onboard Images provides our in-car camera coverage for each USAR Hooters Pro Cup events. And AtTrak Communications comes from the folks at Racing Electronics. AtTrak Transportation is courtesy of our friends at Club Car. iCard is the official timing and scoring provider of the USAR Hooters Pro Cup Series. For Scott Sutherland and Brett McMillan, I'm Rick Benjamin, congratulating the winner, Clay Rogers, of the Charlie Campbell Memorial Miller Lite 250. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time from Mansfield.